Actress Jordana Spiro is here, actress no more, actress and director. We're going to get to her own project in just a minute. We remember My Boys and Dexter, and of course, what we have to ask you about is Ozark. And I wonder if you had this experience as other Netflix newcomers have had. When the show dropped, how quickly did people go, wait a minute, you're in that show?
Yeah, really, really quickly. And then it spreads very quickly. It's like an immediate kind of global effect where it's like I got the opportunity to go to Iceland a couple of weeks ago, and somebody in Iceland was like, Ozark, I love that show. And it was so wild. It's awesome.
And did they say that to you in Icelandic or in English?
In English.
Okay, fair enough.
It was one very, very, very long word.
Yeah. I mean, that show, it is just terrific. You are involved with season two. I know you can't tell us anything. Tell us everything.
Yeah.
No, all I can say is it's awesome. It's even more exciting than the first. And it's just the best show to work for. I pinch myself that I'm working on it. I really am so thrilled.
The last we saw you, you seemed to sort of get away clean. You got dough and you were out.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Well, is getaway clean still a fair phrase?
You're searching.
Yeah. And she's on to you.
She's on to me. Let me show you a little bit of Ozark from last season. Watch.
Great. Thank you.
Do you know, last week, after the O'Connors came in for brunch, that they got home to find out that they were without jewelry, TV, stereo equipment? Well, I know you're only a dishwasher, but just so we're clear here, people have certain expectations when they come to a place like this, okay? They want clean silverware. They want unlimited refills on their coffee. And they want to know that when they are done eating and they come home, all their is still going to be there.
Oh, well, wow. There's a lot going on with her, too.
Okay.
So here's the interesting thing. You have all this acting success, but you elected to return to school. Mm-hmm. Why?
You know, I really wanted to just be the driver of my own stories. I felt like I had some things to say. And I wanted to get a foundation underneath me to really understand how to write scripts and how to direct and all of that. And so I just did that.
All right. And all of that comes out to the directorial debut. It's called Night Comes On. Mm-hmm. You premiere at Sundance. Yes. You get a jury award.
Yeah.
And now we're going to tell people for an opportunity to see us. Tell us about this movie.
So Night Comes On is about a young woman named Angel who gets out of juvenile detention on her 18th birthday, and she wants to avenge her mother's death. But the only person who knows where that person is her 9-year-old little sister, who, of course, she wants to have nothing to do with because she's about to go do this terribly destructive thing. And for me, it was really a chance to have some great female roles and to also get a chance to explore a little bit what happens to some kids that come out of the foster system and how they're really left without a lot of support.
And defend on their own.
Completely.
There's a lot made about this notion. Statistically, there are very few female directors. Mm-hmm. Now that you've broken that barrier to a degree, what about that? Would you like to do more of it?
Absolutely, absolutely. In a perfect world, I'd get to balance the both because they feel like very, very different things to me. So one is sort of a relief from the other, you know?
And could you ever see yourself in a project where you're in front of the camera and directing?
No, not yet. I'll never say never.
Right.
But Jason Bateman does that so beautifully.
And do you think that's weird? I would think that would be hard to do.
He's incredible at it. You know, he had the funniest thing to say one time when I asked him about it. He said, well, you know, the time I have to spend sort of watching playback and watching takes and everything that, you know, kind of slows the day down is the time I don't have to spend dealing with, because I already know with the neurosis of my lead actor.
There you go, counsel himself. Has this made you more conscious of what to say? Because you're a successful actress, as a director, you're better able to communicate with actors now.
I think so. I think you know, a lot of directors that I, you know, friends of mine that say that that they don't know how to talk to actors or whatever, just because they feel like they're not comfortable. And so I feel like that's something that I'm just inherently comfortable with. So that's good.
All's been explained. All right. Ozark season 2 will drop August 31st. Night Comes On is in theaters and on demand. A little later on this week. That happens on August the 3rd. Mm-hmm. Morning News for Monday. We'll be right back. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.